One of my favorite business books out there is The E-Myth Revisited, where they pose a very interesting question for business owners. How can I give my customer the results he wants systematically rather than personally? Put another way, how can I create a business whose results are systems dependent rather than people dependent? And one way that we can give our customers the same result every time that they come to us is by automating processes. And since mine is a service-based business, I'm an Notion consultant, I have standardized and automated the whole process, well, except providing the service itself, of course. I even automated all the emails that I send my clients. So this is what I want to show you in this video. Let me show you around. Okay, so let's put ourselves in the shoes of Bob. Bob is a prospective client, and it's the example that I'm gonna be using to show you what is the entire customer journey that I deliver to my clients. So Bob is scrolling Twitter, he found my profile over here, and he checked a little bit of my tweets. Oh, this guy is cool. Oh, certified Notion consultant. This is cool too. Okay, I trust it. So he's going to book the first call with me. He will select a time. Well, this is a little bit early for me, but okay. Then he will put all his information here and he will schedule the event. Okay, so far there is already automations running in the background, because what Bob just did was to introduce himself into my consultations database, and he was introduced as a lead. So I am doing this with this automation over here. So all these automations are done in Zapier, and what this does is whenever somebody creates a Calendly with me, I will filter by that kind of event, and then I'm gonna create the entry in the consultations database. And here we have Bob's page. So far all of this was automated. So now one side note, when we are trying to systemize and automate systems for our business or for our life, it doesn't really matter, it is very important that we also standardize every step. So for example, for my consulting business, I am just accepting calls through that very Calendly link, because if I was using different links all the time, my automation will stop working because it will just work with one of them. So it is very important that we standardize every step. So now we are gonna wait until the intro call arrives. And whenever that happens, I have this coaching template over here in which I have everything that I need. This is for the intro call, where I have some questions that is going to help me guide the call. So during the call, we will just go through these ones. So now we finish the call. Then let's say that Bob is interested. So I'm going to send him a proposal, and this is something that I have ready over here. Then I will just have to change some parts of the text and share this page with him so he can make any comment or ask me any doubt that he has. And then since every project is different, this is a step that we cannot really fully automate, so we will have to do some manual work. But well, having this template really helps. So once I have sent Bob the email with the proposal, then I have here the possibility to remind me to talk to Bob after X number of days. So let's say that I want to reach him after 7 days, and the status will be already proposal sent. So this formula over here is going to tell me when I need to reach Bob in case that he didn't answer me in 7 days. Because you know, sometimes life happens and people don't respond. That's all good. That's why I have this over here, so I can remember to catch up with him. And then how am I gonna know that I have to reach Bob? Well, if I go to my focus page, so this is the things that I want to do today, he will appear over here in the to reach tab. So whenever Bob appears here, then I'm gonna reach out and so on. Okay, so now after sending Bob the proposal, let's say that for the sake of this video, and because we want to show you the whole workflow until the very end, Bob accepts my offer. So now it is time for Bob to pay me. So I have already put here the price for the services, and the only thing that I have to do is to bring this to Stripe payment. And this is going to trigger a new automation. Let me change the email, so because a new automated email is gonna be sent. And what this automation is going to do is the following. In this app called The Gist, I have a watcher, I don't know how to call it, that whenever the status matches a waiting for payment or Stripe payment in our case, this one is going to give all the data to Zapier, and we will catch the webhook over here. And the automation is gonna be to create the product in Stripe, to create the price in Stripe, because remember, we have the price over here, create the payment link, so Bob, in this case, can pay us through the link, and to send Bob an email with this data. Okay, so let's see if we got any email. Okay, here it is. This is the email that Bob received. So whenever he goes here, yeah, this will be the price that we set in Notion, and he will just have to pay over here. Well, of course, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to spend 1,500 euros to continue this demonstration. So maybe I should have put 1 euro. But well, the process will be, yes, to fill the cart and pay. And once Bob pays, another automation is going to be triggered, which is this one over here. So whenever we receive a new payment, I'm gonna create one entry in my money movements database. So like this, I'm gonna know how much revenue I'm getting every month. And this just filters that is over 500 euros. So I filter out the small payments. And then I'm going to update the database in Notion. This is, I'm gonna put here that Bob paid 1,500 euros. And then I'm gonna create the Google Drive that is gonna be the place where we are gonna be storing all our videos, our assets and everything. I'm gonna enable the file sharing so Bob can actually access the folder. And I'm gonna update the database item in Notion again. So I will automatically put in here the Google Drive link of our folder. And then I'm going to send him an email with this text. So everything is set up. Here is the Google Drive. And I'm also going to be sharing with him a type form. So this is the onboarding questionnaire that I'm gonna be sending automatically to Bob. So I can understand how to better serve him, like in which position he is. And so then we can compare to when we finish our service. And so we can better understand what went on during the whole process. So once Bob has filled the type form with all the questions, this fourth automation is going to start, and this is just basically bringing all the type form information into our Google Sheets. So then we can have in one column the pre-service data, and in another column in the future, the post-service data. I prefer to do it in Google Sheets, honestly, because in Notion it is not that clean, so I will have to create an extra property, and I don't know. I just prefer to do it in Google Sheets, so I have all the information of all my clients in that same sheet. Oh, another thing that I didn't tell you is that whenever he pays, he will go directly to this state. Okay, this is also automatic. So now it is part of the non-automatable process, that is me providing the service to Bob. So let's say that we have already finished the service. And then the last thing that I want Bob to do will be to do the offboarding questionnaire, so we can understand how he improved with me and all this kind of stuff. So the only thing that I will have to do is just to change the status to completed. And this is gonna trigger another automation. So how is this being triggered? Because again, I'm using the Gist, which is amazing because he's able to listen to all these little details. So whenever the status matches this, then a new automation is going to get triggered, which is the offboarding, sending goodbye. And this basically just sends an email to Bob to actually do the offboarding form. And finally, of course, whenever Bob is going to fill the form from Typeform, I'm just gonna write the data into the Google Sheets. So there is no much mystery here. So why is it important to do these offboarding questionnaires? Well, because like this, I can understand how I have helped the client, and most important of all, how could I have done it better? So like this, I will be able to improve for my newer clients, and every service that I fulfill, I'm just going to get better and better, which is, of course, what we all strive for. Okay, so as you can see, I have automated all the admin work of adding data, sending emails and stuff, because the process is always the same. It's a standard process. And I am just focusing on fulfilling the service itself, which is what I'm good at. And now, being completely sincere, this process maybe just works for 90% of the clients. There is 10% that maybe have some special requests, maybe a different payment method they want. Like, so these automations cannot work exactly for 100% of the clients, but well, it works for 90%, so it's pretty enough. And if you wanna be like Bob and you want me to help you with your business systems in Notion, automations and whatever, I'm gonna leave a link in the description of this video where you can book a first call with me and where we can go over your business systems. So, that is it for today, guys, and as always, hasta la próxima.